virus, COVID-19, pandemic.
Hello and welcome to today's performance. My name is Tias and allow me to be your host for this evening. Asia possesses unique and diverse musical traditions that not only awe the world, but also influence others, particularly amongst Western music circles. But up to this day, Asia has been a market for other music, mostly Western pop, rather than having its roots or traditional music at the forefront of music culture. Indonesian music, particularly gamelan, offers abundance and innovation that has inspired many great composers and musicians. Since the late 1800s, authentic Asian music has influenced classical, jazz, and rock music, to name but a few. The pentatonic scale, 3-meter drone, repetition, polyrhythms, and interlocking rhythms, and unique melodies typical to much authentic Asian music has been absorbed and developed by the West and interpreted in their own manner. So, while others appreciate authentic Asian music, why do most Asians seem to choose to imitate Western and popular music? Surely, there's nothing wrong with enjoying and playing other people's music. But without innovation and cultivation of one's own heritage, it would detrimentally affect cultural preservation and development. Asia is believed to be the future center of the world, but this should not be a matter of economics. It should be cultural. To be the world's cultural compass, Asia should nourish her own roots, heritage, and identity that made it Asia in the first place. How could they be nurtured if everyone would rather imitate ideas out of the context that no one ever has ever lived in? For the next music performance, we will listen to two compositions by Aris Daryono, a London-based musician and composer who passionately seeks to promote new music for gamelan in the United Kingdom and beyond. But before that, let's enjoy a Western offering seasoned with Eastern spices. So please welcome our brother from Oxfordshire, UK, Jonathan Wiseman.
Hi everybody, my name is John Wiseman and I'm a guitarist and musician from Oxfordshire, United Kingdom. I'm also the director of Tradisi Records, who are a proud partner of the Sacred Rhythm Reborn Unison Festival. Now, as I cannot be with you in person in Indonesia, I am going to play a short improvisation as a contribution to the festival. I hope you enjoy, and I bring and wish everybody love, peace and harmony for the music and the art that we're going to share together.
Thank you.
After spending several years mastering his skills in composing music for gamelan, Western music, and electronics for his Ph.D, Aris Daryono showcases his old and new compositions, Distance and Papat, for this event. His music reflects his musical background as a traditional gamelan musician and a composer who has been also trained in Western classical music. In his music, he explores drones, interlocking patterns, repetition, tempo changes, and layering. He is also fascinated with creating a range of sonorities and microtones within his collaborations for gamelan and for other instruments. His role in continuously transmitting knowledge from both Indonesian and Western practices is important, particularly for younger generations of upcoming artists and composers. But other equally important value is his effort in bringing people together and bridging diverse musical traditions from corners of the world through Gamelan Composers Forum, of which he founded. Not many people know that Aris was also formally trained in classical guitar at Institut Seni Indonesia or Indonesia Art Institute. I wonder if Aris also created some composition for guitar and gamelan. Please enjoy his presentation.
Thank you. COVID-19.